Hello everyone and welcome back to another PowerPoint text animation tutorial. The animation is inspired by the work of Matt Voice at Behance.net. In 2018, we had also published a tutorial on spin text animation, where we used almost the same technique that we are going to demonstrate in this tutorial. The link to that video is given in the description and in the cards. Here we have two slides in this presentation, and if we open the selection pane from the Home tab, then you can see all the objects that we used to design both the slides. The number of layers on the second slide is more than the first slide. And if we see the slideshow again, then the animation effect is also slightly different. There are a total of 16 layers on the first slide, and if we open the animation pane from the Animations tab, then you can see that 48 animation effects have been applied to these layers. That is 3 spin effects on each of the layers. As we have 7 letters in the text and each letter is having 4 layers of different colors, we have a total of 28 layers on the second slide. Now, let's take a look at the design on the first slide. If we hide all the layers except for the first one, then you can see that it represents 2 letters of the text, the letter O and the letter R of white color. Both letters have been grouped into a single layer. On a new slide, type the text that you want to animate. As we want to animate each of the letters separately, it is important to have each letter in a separate text box. In our previous, easy text animation in PowerPoint tutorial, we converted the text into shapes by typing the text first, and then drawing a rectangle on top. Send the rectangle to the back of the text. Now, select the rectangle first, and then the text by holding the Shift key. From the Format Shape tab, use the Fragment command from the Merge Shapes drop-down menu, and there you have each letter as a separate shape. If you see the animation in slow motion, then you can notice that the letter O and R starts to move at the same time. Then the letter C and E move together, and then the letters T and B. The letter O in the middle of the text is just spinning on its own axis. Moreover, the letter O first spin a little bit counterclockwise, and then clockwise, and again a bit counterclockwise. The letter R also follows the same spin directions. So, we draw an oval shape and then grouped both the letters with the oval. Later, we hide the oval using no fill and no outline commands from the Shape Format tab. Now, we will apply the first spin effect from the Add Animations drop-down menu of the Animations tab. The first spin effect will be of 3 degrees counterclockwise, without any start or end smoothness, while having a time duration of 0.50 seconds. Then we will again apply the spin effect the second time and will rotate it at 375 degrees with the default start and end smoothness. The time duration will be 3 seconds with a delay of 0.50 seconds. Then we will again add the spin effect the third time, and this time we will rotate it 12 degrees counterclockwise, while only having the end smoothness with a time duration of 0.50 seconds and delay timings of 3.50 seconds. If you now see the slideshow, then both the letters will start spinning together, and we have one set of the white color is ready. We will make a duplicate of this layer by using the copy and paste command from the Home tab. Place this duplicate layer exactly in the same position and change the fill color from the shape format. Send it back and then start adding a delay timing of 0.10 seconds to each of the spin effects for the red color layer. Let me demonstrate the process one last time for more clarification. Copy and paste the group letters layer, and place it exactly on top of the previous. The red guides will help you to know the exact position. Change the fill color as required. The oval shape grouped with the letters will also get visible after you fill the color. So, select the oval shape within from the group and use no fill and no outline to hide. The new layer will have the same three spin animation effects and you only need to change the delay timings. This time, we will add a delay of 0.20 seconds to each of the spin effects. See the slideshow and there you have three layers of different colors spinning one after another. So, we used the same technique on the first slide to create four layers of a different color for each of the letter groups. Following the same method, we then grouped the letter C and the letter E together with an oval shape. You can note that the same spin effect has been applied and the only difference is between the delay timings of each of the different color grouped layers. Like, the first letter C and E layer have a delay timing of 0.10 seconds, the second has 0.20 seconds, the third has 0.30 seconds, and the fourth layer is moving at the delay of 0.40 seconds. In the same way, we grouped the letter T and the letter B. The letter O in the middle is alone while also having four layers of a different color. You can download this presentation from the link in the video description and can note down the design, animation effects, and delay timings we used for each layer group. The only difference between the first and the second slide is that we placed each letter in a separate layer as you can see in the selection pane. If we turn on all the layers of the first letter O, then you can see only the corresponding effects in the animation pane. You can note down the time duration and delay timings between each of the spin effects. Same way, you can turn on all four layers of the second letter C, and then can note down the duration and delay timings. So, I hope you might have got my point and have learned something new and interesting. Let me know by liking, sharing, and commenting on this video. Don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon as there are a lot more tutorials to come. Thanks a lot for watching and do take good care of yourself.